What if I told you there's a cheat sheet that unlocks the secrets of the universe, a key that unlocks the basic building blocks of everything around us, from the air we breathe to the metal in our smartphones? Well, guess what? This mystical key does exist, and it's known as the periodic table. In this video, we'll explore the mysteries hidden within this scientific marvel. Get ready to discover how it organizes the fundamental elements that comprise our reality. Let's start with the basics. The periodic table is a chart that arranges chemical elements by their atomic number, electron configuration, and chemical properties. It's divided into rows and columns. The rows are known as periods. The atomic number increases as you move from left to right across a period. The columns are called groups. Elements in the same group have properties that are similar. Now, what exactly does the atomic number mean? It denotes the number of protons in an atom's nucleus. This number defines and identifies an element. For example, hydrogen has one proton, helium has two, and so on. As the atomic number increases across a period, you might expect the atoms to grow larger. But in fact, they usually get smaller. Why is that? Here's the deal. Adding more protons increases the positive charge in the nucleus. This charge pulls the electrons closer to the nucleus, causing the atom to shrink. So even though the atomic number goes up, the strong charge of the nucleus compacts the electrons down to a smaller overall size. It's like squeezing a sponge. The opposite thing happens when moving down in groups. Although more protons are added, more electron shells also form. This expanding electron cloud outweighs the charge of the nucleus, allowing atoms to swell in size. Now that we've seen how rows and columns relate to atomic size, let's take a closer look at the orbital blocks, namely the S, P, D, and F blocks. This is where things really get interesting. Orbitals are regions within an atom where electrons hang out. Each orbital has a specific shape and can only hold a certain number of electrons. The outermost orbital of an element defines which block it belongs to. Let's start with the S block on the far left. This includes elements with their outer electrons in an S orbital, such as hydrogen and helium. S orbitals are spherical in shape and can hold up to two electrons. The P block is on the far right, and it contains elements with outer electrons in P orbitals. P orbitals can accommodate up to six electrons. The P block contains a rich variety of elements, from reactive nonmetals to semi-metallic metalloids. In the middle, we have the D block, home of the transition metals. These elements have outer electrons in D orbitals, which can hold a maximum of 10 electrons. Transition metals are great conductors and have high melting points. Finally, the rare earth lanthanides and actinides are found in the F block at the bottom. Their outermost electrons are generally in F orbitals, which have a capacity of 14 electrons. Understanding orbital blocks allows you to predict how elements will behave. It unlocks their chemical properties. All right, that concludes this brief tour of the periodic table. Please let me know in the comments if you'd like me to explain more about this amazing scientific tool. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos on chemistry and other sciences.